You are watching Lifeline, a production of Lifeline Media and United Christian Fellowship of Arlington. Enjoy and be blessed.
Deliverance in the midst of that crisis. Praise the name of Jesus. The last point that that verse is telling us, it says, and rivers in the desert. Now we know that the desert is a wilderness, a place of dryness, a place of lack, a place whereby nothing is expected, little or nothing is expected. The only thing they can expect from a desert will be disaster, will be loneliness, will be dryness, a place where nothing seems to work. The Spirit of God comes to us this evening, and it says rivers in the desert. You see, that talks about provision of God. It talks about the provisions of God in the midst of lack. It talks about the provisions of God in the midst of not knowing what to do. It talks about the provisions of God in the place of want, in the place of loneliness, in the place of destitute, in the place of being forsaken. The Spirit of God comes to us this evening, making provisions for us. He says, rivers in the desert. So, child of God, be encouraged. Just because you are alive today, it means God still has you in mind. It means that circumstances can still change. It means that the word of God can still come true. Do not give up on God. The songwriter says, don't give up on God, for he will not give up on you. He is able. I want you to be strengthened in your heart. Now ask yourself a question. What will it take for you to trust God? Nothing. All what it takes for you to do is just to tell yourself, Lord, I may not know how I'm going to figure this out. But one thing I know for sure is that you are God all over your world. Your word says heaven and earth will pass, your word will not pass without coming to manifestation. So, church, I want you to be strengthened in your heart. No matter what the situation is, and I'm happy that you can still pray. No matter what the situation is, I'm happy you're with your right senses. No matter what the situation is, the word of God stands true for your life this evening. So be encouraged in your faith, even as we approach God, lifting the word of God back to God. And say, Father, honor your word over the church. Honor your word over our lives. Honor your word over the circumstances of our lives. In the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. The word of God says to us again, I will do a new thing. I will do a new thing. In Jesus' mighty name. So as a family this night, we want to lift up these items before God. And like I said, all what you need to do is believe God in your heart. Just trust God like a baby. Just trust God like a child.
Yes, sir.
When a father tells a child, oh, when I come up, I'm going to buy you a car. The child believes it. Why? Because even if the father is in love, the child believes, well, whatever daddy says is true. Why can't we have that attitude towards God? That whatever he says concerning our life, it will come true. In the mighty name of Jesus. With faith in your heart, church, I want you to say, Lord, in the name of Jesus, please open my eyes to see the new things you have planned out for my life. Open your mouth and make that a prayer unto God. The God that is able to do exceedingly abundantly above our thoughts and imagination. Lord, open our eyes. Open our eyes. That I will see that new thing. Your word says, I will do a new thing. Behold, open my eyes, O God. I refuse to exist blindly. I refuse to have the eyes in the physical, but in the spiritual, I'm blinded. Lord, open my eyes, open the eyes of the church to behold this new thing that you are bringing to us. To behold this new thing in our marriages. To behold this new thing in our career. To behold this new thing in our ministry. To behold this new thing in the world that we are living in. Father, your word says, I will do anything. Lord, open our eyes to appreciate this. Lord, that we are not missing it. This new thing, Lord. Father, whatever it means, O God, your word says, behold, our eyes have seen of the goodness of the Lord. Father, we profess what we see in the realm of the Spirit. Our spiritual senses are enlightened. Our spiritual senses are heightened. Our eyes are open in the realms of the Spirit. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
The next prayer was, say, every promise of God for me. Now, help me, please. Say, every promise of God for me and my household. That is a prophecy over you. Open your mouth and declare it. Father, whatever you have promised, whatever it is that your mouth has declared concerning my house, concerning my life, concerning my career, concerning my well-being, concerning my health, concerning my ministry, Lord, in the name of Jesus, they come to pass. They come to realization. They come to manifestation in the mighty name of Jesus. Every promise of God, we refuse to live without activating them. Whatever is meant for the church for the now, Lord, they become a reality in our lives, oh God. Your word says, give the Lord no rest. Give the Lord no rest. You have made mention of the Lord. Father, we follow you by the reason of your word. We come to you by the reason of your word. Every promise of God concerning our health, concerning our career, concerning our children, concerning our grandchildren, concerning our profession, Father, in the name of Jesus, they come true. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
God, the dead promise said, Father, every spirit of delay in my life, I rebuke you. Open your mouth and talk to God. Whatever it is that God has promised you, it comes to pass and on time. Every spirit of delay. The word of God makes us understand that Daniel prayed unto God, and God answered the prayers of Daniel. But the word of God says that there were some principalities called the prince of Persia. They withstood the prayers of Daniel, that it did not get to him until there was a reinforcement in the realms of the spirit. Open your mouth and say, Father, every delay, whatever it is, O God, that has been released for me, but it's been delayed by the agent or restriction from the pit of hell, in the name of Jesus, we rebuke, Lord, by that power of delay. Father, whatever is hanging in the air, whatever has to do with my destiny, whatever has to do with my ministry, whatever has to do with my life moving forward, that is delayed by the agency of the devil, we stand on the finished work of Jesus. And Father, we declare manifestation in Jesus' mighty name. The fourth prayer upon Leslie, the faith to actualize new things. Leslie said the faith to actualize new things from God. And for me and my household, I receive it in Jesus' name. Open your mouth and declare. You need that faith from God to be able to actualize, to bring to manifestation that which God has promised. The word of God said, I will do a new thing. But you need faith to bring it to manifestation. Open your mouth and say, Father, the faith to bring it to manifestation. Father, we take it away from the rest of the spiritual. Let it come to the manifestation in the physical. Child of God, it profits the church nothing. It profits the church nothing. If all our blessings are in the spiritual, and here in the physical, there is no manifestation. Here in the spirit, in the physical, there is no evidence. Here in the physical, nothing to show for it. Open your mouth this evening. Lord, the faith of the Lord Jesus Christ. To see the manifestation of the blessings of God. Father, upon us, upon our family members, in the mighty name of Jesus, they become a reality. They become a reality. We receive this faith, O God. The faith, O God, that can pull down mountains. The faith, O God, that can bring down strongholds. The faith, O God, that can cause a release, Lord, in the realms of the Spirit, concerning the things that has been in their life. Concerning the things that have to do with our children. Concerning the things that have to do with the church of God. Concerning the things that have to do with our doctrine. Father, in the name of Jesus, we stand over the promises of God. Under this corporate anointing, and Lord, we make this declaration based on the word of God, that you will do a new thing. Lord, we receive that faith, O God. Father, Lord God, the faith that is not distracted. The faith that is not looking at the negative. Yes. The faith that is not looking for symptoms, but looking for healing. The faith that is not looking for lack, but looking for supply. The faith that is not looking behind, but is looking forward. Lord, that faith, yes, Lord, it becomes a reality, yes, Lord, in our lives, Lord, in the mighty name of Jesus. Amen. Father, take away the spirit of doubt. Yes. Whatever makes for doubt, experiences that are sad, experiences enemies that will make us weak, secret tears. Lord, we refuse to cry anymore. For the word of God has come to us. Your word says, say to the children of God, it shall be well with you. Say to the righteous, it is well with you. Father, I declare over everyone under the sound of my voice, the people at home, the people in the sanctuary, even as they open their mouth by faith, Jehovah, Heavenly Father, it is well with the children of God. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, you promised us the Egyptians that we see today. These Egyptians will be no more. Father, whatever represents Egyptian, whatever is that strong man, whatever is that strong power, whatever is that principality, whatever is that thing that mocks the faith of the church, Father, in the name of Jesus, we receive the faith to go beyond them. Father, they go long before high. In the mighty name of Jesus. In Jesus' name we pray. Say the grace of God for deliverance. Come upon me now. Open your mouth and talk to God. Deliverance from negativity. Deliverance from setback. Deliverance from evil of any kind. Deliverance from me, from my children, from my grandchildren. Whatever it is, deliverance from my job, from my career. The grace of God for deliverance. Deliverance from every form of negativity. It comes through in our lives this evening. In the mighty name of Jesus, whatever has been bound, whatever was tied up in the realms of the Spirit, whatever was tied up in the realms of the Spirit, by the mercy of God, under divine unction, under this corporate anointing, under the word of God that has come to us, Jehovah, we are delivered. In the name of Jesus, we receive deliverance, Lord. For who the Son has set free, Father, is free indeed. We declare our deliverance. We refuse to negotiate it. We refuse to be dormant about it. We refuse to be quiet about it. Deliverance from negativity. Deliverance from poverty. Deliverance from pain. Deliverance from protracted illness. Deliverance from untimely death. Deliverance from not being successful. In Jesus' mighty name. The final one, he says, let's say every spirit of lack. I rebuke you from my life. Open your mouth and rebuke every spirit of lack. Every spirit of lack. The word of God says, rivers in the desert. He talks about provision. Every spirit of lack. Lack of ideas. Lack of faith in God. Lack of confidence in the things of the Spirit. Lack of purity. Lack of commitment in the place of prayer and the story of the world. Lack of the love of God. It is taken away from us in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, it is taken away from us in the mighty name of Jesus. Spirit of lack, you have no part to play in our lives. And you are gone forever. We refuse to lack. For the word of God says that he that was rich became poor, so that in his poverty we might know how to not live in lack. We refuse to lack. The benefits of God, they are evident in our lives. Let your name be glorified. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed. Spirit of God, we thank you for the strength of your word. We thank you for the power behind your word. We thank you because heaven and earth will pass, but your word cannot pass. Lord, the integrity of your name is at stake, attached to your word. And Lord God, we have lifted up this prayer, this prophecy that we gave to the people of God. We attach ourselves to this prophecy. For your word says, whatever is of good report, think of these things. Father, we have applied these things, oh God, concerning the circumstances of our life, concerning the health of the church, concerning the children of the church, concerning the profession of the church member, concerning everything that has to do with the church member, everyone that is watching over the airway. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, even as your word has promised us this evening, that Lord, you will do a new thing. Father, we position ourselves rightly to receive of this new thing in the mighty name of Jesus. Your word says, when the Son of God comes, will he find faith on the earth? Spirit of God, we declare, even as we have prayed, Lord, our confidence is in the word of God. Concerning our lives, oh God, that Lord, every provision, every deliverance, everything that you have set, oh God, for the church, oh God, for us, we refuse to not get this. We refuse to act, oh God, ignorantly.
Father, we receive these by faith in the mighty name of Jesus. Lord, let your name be glorified. Let your name be magnified. For we pray in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' mighty name we have prayed.
Amen.
Let us put our hands together and celebrate the Lordship of Jesus. The shouting side is the winning side. Praise the Lord! Hallelujah! Amen. We want to thank the Lord for what the Lord has done for us this evening.
Yeah.
The prayers that the Lord has raised in our midst.
Yeah.
We thank God because every prayer prayed,
yeah,
the answers we receive.
Yes.
We walk in the manifestation of the blessings of God. Tied to the word of God from Isaiah 43 verse 19.
Yes.
For us, for our church, for our loved ones, in the mighty name of Jesus.
You've been watching Lifeline, a production of Lifeline Media and United Christian Fellowship of Arlington. We pray you have been blessed. Subscribe to our channel and follow us online for more Christ-filled content. United Christian Fellowship of Arlington is a diverse church for a diverse world. Thanks for watching.